or morning. Sunday.
I
slept in. So here we go.
Got our way to church.
Everything's dead still. No snow. Everybody else is going woo. Yeah, the Christmas is over. I'm like woohoo. But the grass is green. It's beautiful. And it's raining. This is like one of my favorite things ever. So, yay! It's a good day.
Remember, I will, Jacob, look up at the rabbi. Thank you. The rabbi best friend. Now run home and tell your father that I hope he has a bin full of guests next week. That evening, Jacob's father reminded him of the busy days ahead. Jacob would have to work on his projects in the mornings and help his father in the evenings. The next 3 mornings, Jacob went to the workshop while it was still dark. He was building a new kind of animal feeding box, one of the beetles. The other boys laughed at this project at first, but now that it was almost finished, they weren't laughing anymore. On the last night, Jacob returned to the workshop after helping his father at the inn. "You must finish tonight," thought the sleepy boy. He looked at the four wheels to learn his work finished. "There's so much work still to do." He was so tired. "Maybe if I close my eyes for a few minutes." In what seemed like the very next moment, a beam of starlight fell across Jacob's napping eyes. "What?" he shouted. "Had he slept through the night?" He then looked out and saw the whole village lit up by the shimmering light. Jacob rubbed his feet from his eyes and he went outside. He walked toward the star that seemed to dance in the star. He walked toward the star that seemed to dance in the sky near his father's inn. Now there's a page missing from the book, so I have to fill you in. He went to the inn to see what was going on there, and he saw Mary and Joseph in the main in the stable, and the baby was laying in the hay. "Baby doesn't even have a bed," Jacob thought. He then turned and raced back toward the workshop. He stood beside an empty truck. "It was the best work you've ever done. Tomorrow the rabbi would choose the best project. But tonight there's a new baby without a place to sleep." "This is a big day, boys," Rabbi Simeon said. "We need to get everything ready for my nephew." He looked at Jacob's workbench stacked with the four wheels. "Well, where is your project, Jacob?" "Something happened, sir," Jacob began. "There was a big star, and there was another page missing from the book. Probably that in a moment." "Uncle Simeon?" "Joseph," the rabbi shouted, "I'm so glad you're here." Jacob's eyes grew big. This was the man who was with the baby in the stable. Rabbi Simeon turned to him. "Jacob, this is my nephew." "We've already met," said Joseph. "In fact, Jacob gave my son his very first gift." "Come, I'll show you." Joseph led them toward the inn. "Did you stay at the inn?" the rabbi asked. "Not quite. It was too full." Joseph smiled. He lowered his head and entered the stable. Joseph stepped next to the trough and motioned for them to come closer. "His name is Jesus," Joseph whispered, "and he has a cradle fit for a king. It is the finest project I've seen," the rabbi said to Jacob. "You will be the one to help build God's house. But why did you give your trough away?" "I remembered what you said. When you give a gift to one of God's children, you give a gift to God," said the boy. "And so you have," the rabbi whispered. "So you have."
All right, it's time to say goodnight. Goodnight.